All right, but I'm going to tell you about all the USB-C attachments you can put into USB port on your PS5. So I got the USB-C, the USB-A adapter. If you didn't want a USB-C port on your PS5, stick it in like that. And ta-da, now you got four USB-A ports. Well, let's do something better than that. Let's grab a big one like this. So this one has multiple ports and an SD card. A NOX port and all that. So let's plug this one in to our PS5. So once I do that, as you can see, we plug it in. On the PS5, as I can show you guys, it says I have a headphone symbol. So that means it's detecting if I plug in some headphones, I can play headphones because I have an aux cord in there. And screenshots. When we go to our media gallery, if you go to USB, it actually reads my SD card. So if you have an SD card and want to put some videos on that, you can do that too. But this also makes it more convenient if you want to use mouse and keyboard. And if I plug it into the port, it'll give me that icon that I have a mouse plugged in. And the same thing will happen to keyboard. So if you need to extend your mouse or keyboards, you can do that too. And another thing, you might ask me, well, what about, can you have multiple monitors? So I'm gonna plug this in because this has an HDMI. My TV says my HDMI 3 is available because I have nothing plugged up into it. So let's go to it. So HDMI 3, can you have multiple monitor support? No. Doesn't look like it. It's technically, yep, no signal. So no multiple monitor support. So if you was thinking about having hooking up multiple monitors, that's not going to work. Now, I asked you, well, what about one that is dedicated to it? You can try that again. So let me unplug this. As I said, my mouse and headphones are disconnected. So unplugging now. Let's pick one that's actually dedicated to this task. See? Maybe it was just that, but let's see. My TV says it again. My HDMI 3 is ready. Let's try one that's dedicated to it. Don't think so. So no, that doesn't work. I'm getting a signal as the lights are glowing. So it's definitely getting power. So let's go into our internet setting. Network. Nah, judging from this, it looks like you only have one wire connection. Yeah, judging by this is, let me take out the actual Ethernet. So I took off my internet and now, I guess because the port has power, it's not really gonna go through your USB-C-A. So I took that out. Yeah. No, it doesn't work with LAN cables or internet. And just to be sure, because I'm offline, let's try out our other thing we have. Let's just see the big 13-in-1. Got all these ports. If you was like trying to turn your laptop into a desktop, let me plug in my keyboard and mouse. Keyboard and mouse. And let's plug it in. So on the big ones, it actually may not even work. Oh no, they do. It's just taking a little bit to get some power. And on the screen, my keyboard has showed up. So it took it a little second, but yeah. Say whoever you want the keyboard for. And yeah, so if you have a big dock like this, you can use that as well. And anything else, basically your Ethernet port doesn't work. So you can't replace that if you break that somehow. And none of your displays will work. Alright, so now, what about some USB-C headphones, just in case you want to use them? Got some for my Samsung phones. So, plug this in. Let's see what the PS5 will say, what you get. I plug in the headphones and... No. Even though these do have the microphone on them, it doesn't work. Also, if you try to use a USB-C to aux cord, doesn't work either. So if you wanted to, let's say, have some wired headphones, which I don't know why, you just want to, say, plug it into your controller, you have to use the aux ones to just plug it into your controller. But if you want to plug some headphones into your PS5, it would not work. So I hope this helps you out, and I'll see you later.